Back now, as promised, with tonight's installment of a series we are calling Personal Best and how you can get there. Tonight, the organic trend, a big business, and the question, are people getting what they pay extra for? Here's NBC's Lisa Myers.
They come, rain or shine, packing the tent at the Sarasota Farmers Market to buy organic food.
They have the best cucumbers here. They're really good.
Carrots, avocados, eggplant, radishes.
I would like to have a box of strawberries too, please.
Okay.
Promoted as better for you, organic farming is one of the fastest growing segments of U.S. agriculture, with sales last year estimated at $25 billion, up from $1 billion two decades ago. Many believe organics are more nutritious, but there is actually little scientific evidence of that. We asked dietitian Shia Rarbach to compare conventional and organic lettuce.
Okay, nutritionally, these two samples of lettuce are going to be the same. Big difference is the price. The conventional lettuce is 18 cents an ounce, and the organic is 50 cents an ounce.
It costs more to produce organic food. It's a much more intense method of farming.
What really distinguishes organic products is how they are grown or raised. When you see the U.S. Department of Agriculture's organic seal, it means no synthetic chemicals, no hormones, no antibiotics, and no genetic engineering were used to produce that plant or animal. That alone appeals to a lot of parents.
I just try to give my kids the best food possible, and for me, that's no added pesticides.
Organic farmers argue that it's better for the environment.
Our goal in organic agriculture is to create an ecosystem that is working with nature to grow plants without using toxins.
But critics say that it simply isn't feasible to feed the world without using toxins, that organic farming takes more land and ultimately produces less.
Thank you.
For individual families, the decision about buying organic may come down to whether being chemical and pesticide free is worth the higher price. Lisa Myers, NBC News, Washington.